Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of 60 Formula. Hope you're doing well today. We've got a whole bunch of new subscribers recently. If you're new to the channel, this is Hila on the right, she's the lady of the house, and this is Britney Spears on the left, and he's the man of the house. Now you're probably thinking, wait, whoa, that's a dude? That's a boy husky and his name is Britney Spears? That's right, so if you're not used to it, you better get used to it, bro. That's right. So you've probably come here because you're looking for some information on Siberian Huskies. They're a crazy breed with a really fun personality, but they have a lot of quirks about them that you kind of have to figure out. YouTube is a great place to figure out a whole bunch of different things about your doggo, especially if you have a husky. There's a whole bunch of mysteries to a husky, almost to the point where you're like, dude, are you guys from a different planet? Are you from Mars? So on this channel, we give you all the tricks and the tips, all the information that you need to know whenever you're raising or training a Siberian Huskaroni pizza. Now today, we're gonna go into something that every single Husky owner ever has a problem with. If you have a Siberian Husky at home or you have a Husky puppy, maybe you just have a dog that isn't a Husky at all, you've probably dealt with the problem of pooping and peeing on the floor. I know, I'm telling them all the embarrassing junk, I'm sorry. It's no secret that getting a Siberian Husky means you're gonna be cleaning up a whole bunch of poo and a whole bunch of pee. Accidents just happen. That's the nature of having a dog, especially a Husky, because sometimes Huskies can be very difficult to potty train. Now, I potty trained both of my Siberian Huskies to perfection. And neither of them have accidents in the house or have had accidents for months and months, and I may be so bold to say over a year. One of the biggest questions I get whenever people come to the channel and they visit and they watch the episodes is, dude, I got a husky at home and they will not stop peeing or pooping on the floor. Look at her, she's like, dude, I used to poop and pee on the floor. Yeah, actually, I'm pretty proud of it. It was fun. There are a bunch of ways that you can get your Siberian Husky to stop pooping and stop peeing on your floor. And today, we're gonna go over all the tips and tricks so that if you got a Husky puppy at home or you got a doggo that's just doing the number uno and the numero dos, I'm gonna teach you guys how to fix that problem and eliminate it so you never have to clean up another turd in your entire life. Oh, I said it. Yeah, I said it. This video is gonna teach you how to stop your Husky from pooping and peeing on the floor, and you're never gonna have to clean up another accident again. Look at Hila. She's like, that's impossible. How are you going to teach everyone to do that? Well, come with us, will you, on another episode of 60 Formula, where we find out how to get your Husky to stop going to the bathroom inside your house. Are you guys ready? All right, then let's do it. Okie doke, let's jump right into the good stuff. Let's talk about why Siberian Huskies have a super hard time learning how to use the bathroom outside and why they always make a whole bunch of accidents indoors. First of all, most people get Siberian Huskies as puppies. Most people like to take that plunge because they think Husky puppies are cute and they're like, bro, I'm gonna go all in. I'm gonna raise a Husky from when they're an itty bitty pepperoni pizza and I'm gonna do the whole shebang. I admire people with that kind of passion, but get ready because you just stepped onto the Hulk of doggo roller coasters. And when it comes to pottying, trust me, Siberian Huskies sometimes have a huge issue getting used to it. So because you probably have a Siberian Husky puppy, it's good to know that their bladders are extra small, which means they don't hold a lot of poo and pee inside of their itty bitty pepperoni bodies. Now that may sound funny, but I'm for real. Siberian Husky puppies can only hold their pee and their poo for like 2 hours. You have to take them outside, especially when they're 8 to 10 weeks old, every 2 hours. A lot of people get Siberian Huskies as puppies and they don't understand that Huskies have to go outside and use the potty when they're puppies every 2 hours. That's a lot of going outside and taking your Husky out. Now that we know that bit of information, it's good to also know that Siberian Huskies love to make accidents in places where you're not looking. So if you have areas of your home where there's like a dark corner or an area where you don't really visit a lot, this is an area where your Husky is going to want to take advantage and use the restroom when you're not looking. And this is why we stress the importance of limiting access to the areas of your home to your puppy. Get baby gates and shut the doors to the areas that you don't want your Husky puppy visiting. Because if your Husky puppy gets the opportunity, they're gonna go into those areas or go to those rooms and you're gonna find a tiny little yogurt-sized turd sitting on the floor. So whenever we have a list of things that you should get your Siberian Husky puppy, off the bat we always say baby gates. Baby gates are the best way to keep your Husky puppy in one spot and keep an eye on them. Siberian Huskies are very unlikely to make an accident in front of you. They don't want to do that. They don't want to go pee or poo in front of people. They want to do it when people aren't looking. So if you're keeping them in your eyesight, it's very unlikely that they're going to make that mistake, and you're going to be able to read the signs that, hey, they need to go to the potty. Now, I want to interject here and just say this. A lot of people who get Siberian Huskies have jobs, which means you got to leave your husky at home when you're busy at work. We completely understand. This puts a big wrench in your plans and how you train your Siberian Husky to go potty outside or do anything else. But the number one mistake that you will make when it comes to teaching your husky to being potty trained is buying pee pads. So many people buy pee pads for their husky so that their husky or their dog can use the bathroom inside when they're not at home. They feel bad that they're not able to come home to take their husky out, and they want their husky to be able to relieve themselves. If you give your husky a pee pad or teach them to use a pee pad when you aren't at home, this is directly going to teach your Siberian husky that peeing inside or pooing inside the house is okay, and it's so hard to unlearn something than it is to teach someone that has a fresh mind. This is what Hila does now during episodes. She's like on strike. She's like, I'm gonna lay flat on the floor like a pancake because I'm gonna join my bro, Ruby Tuesday, underneath the table, and we're gonna flop. Yeah, we're just gonna be lazy today. Okay, so starting the actual process of potty training your husky, there's a few things that you need to know going into it. First is that you need to be proactive. That's one of the most important parts of this whole thing. You need to keep an eye on your husky, and there will be times where you're gonna take your Siberian husky out to use the restroom, out to potty, and they are going to sit there and sniff and sniff and sniff for what seems like forever. Sometimes you're gonna have to wait for your husky to use the bathroom for up to 20 or 30 minutes, and you're gonna wanna poke your own eyeballs out. And I know this is gonna be frustrating, but you just have to be patient. Patience is a big part of potty training your Siberian Husky, and the more that you have, the quicker that this process is going to go. Now, as long as you're keeping your Siberian Husky close to you, you have them in the same room, and you're always keeping an eye on them, all you have to do in order to make sure that you're getting them outside to go to the bathroom and avoiding those accidents is looking for signs. Now, I know what you're thinking, like, what sort of signs do I need to look for? Like, you know, like crop circles in the middle of my living room? No, the kind of signs you want to look for whenever you're Siberian Husky puppy has to go outside and go potty is sniffing, pacing, and a sudden loss of attention in something that they're doing is probably a good indication that, hey, they gotta go to the bathroom. Now, these are key moments for you whenever you find these moments in time to do your training, because when you see them sniffing around or pacing or they lose interest in something and it is potty time, you wanna strap them to a leash as quickly as possible and get them outside. If they go to the bathroom right away, what you want to do is act like it is literally your birthday. You want to jump up and down, do cartwheels all over the place, make high-pitched noises, and go, oh my God, you're my best friend. Oh my Lord, you did it. Here's a treat for you, and here's a treat for you. Ooh, and he lost his treat.
Did you get it, bro? Okay, you got it. Okay, we can continue.
Giving your Siberian Husky treats and praising them whenever they go to the potty is something that's gonna make them want to continue that behavior over and over and over. So if you give them treats, if you pet them, if you freak out and make them happy and play with them, chances are going outside and going potty is gonna become one of their very favorite things to do. Now, we wanna stress getting angry and getting mad whenever you find some poop on the floor or pee is not going to help the situation. It doesn't teach your husky anything. Trust me, it's been tested for years and centuries and millennia, and hitting or being mad or yelling or screaming at your husky whenever they make an accident, it absolutely does nothing. If you catch your Siberian Husky making an accident in your home, that is when you can pick them up, take them outside, and then praise them when they finish going to the potty outdoors. I know a lot of people don't want to pick their animal up whenever they're in the middle of using the bathroom. First of all, your dog will probably freak out, and you don't want to get any, you know, pee or poo on you. But picking them up and moving them outside is a great opportunity to teach them that what they're doing in that that moment, because dogs learn best whenever you teach them in the moment, that using the restroom outside is the best way to go. In fact, catching your husky making an accident indoors, actually physically catching them and then moving them outside, is one of the best opportunities that you will get to teach or train your husky not to use the potty indoors. So now listen, I know every single situation is different. Some of us can't be at home, right? We have jobs and we have things we gotta do. Like Gila, she's gotta do this YouTube channel and she's like, ugh, God, just ugh. We always encourage crate training when it comes to Siberian Huskies on this channel. It teaches them so much. It prevents accidents when you're away, and it also teaches routine and scheduling. If you can't be at home, consider getting a crate and crate training your Siberian Husky. You can't leave them in there when they're a puppy for more than 2 hours, so it doesn't mean you're gonna get to go out and do whatever you want all the time. And yes, it is going to be messy. But crate training is a great way to expedite that potty training process. And by the way, if we haven't said already, routine and scheduling is the best way to potty train. The next step that you need to do, and it's the very final one, is just to practice. Reward heavily for potty training outside. Use high value treats. Remember, go to the exact same location every single time you take your husky puppy out to pee. Don't go to a different spot every time. Use the same spot. They're gonna smell their pee and their poo from before, and they're gonna be like, oh dude, I know exactly what this spot is. This is the place where I do that, you know, that thing. A lot of people don't go to the same location every time. They like to switch it up, and this confuses husky puppies. He's like, dude, my sister's butt is touching my butt right now, and I can hardly do this episode and handle it. Gila, your butt is touching your brother's butt. She don't care. We also encourage bell training, which is where you take a bell, you hang it from a string, you put it on your doorknob, and you ring it every single time you take your husky out to go to the bathroom. Anytime you go out, forever, ring that bell yourself. But always make sure that bell is low enough to the ground for your husky to ring it. Eventually, whenever your husky wants to use the restroom, they're gonna start ringing that bell all by themselves. And that's them telling you, hey, I gotta go to the bathroom. And you won't even need to wonder or think about looking after your husky anymore, because they'll basically have a system where they tell you when they have to go to the bathroom. Training a husky is super simple. You just have to make sure you stick to a routine and you do everything we mentioned in this video. Potty training is no joke with a Siberian husky, and it can be tough, but we promise if you follow our steps and you listen to everything we said in this video, your Siberian husky is gonna be potty trained in literally no time. It's guaranteed. And if you have any comments or any questions, leave them down below. We'll help you through the process of potty training your Siberian Husky. If you guys had fun today, don't forget to smash that like button and hit subscribe so you don't miss any more Huskaroni Pizza episodes and you stay up to date with all the tips, tricks, and great knowledge that you need to know when it comes to Siberian Huskies. We had a blast hanging out with you, but until next time, we'll see you with another episode of guess what? Yep, you guessed it. Whatever we make. Peace!